Hi guys, Chuffy here again, and another little update on the pre-heresy army that I'm building. What you see here is actually two squads I've already done. I did these back in part 4 and 5, and I wanted just to go through with the things that I've done since that day. Since 4 and 5, the unit actually had a power axe here with this sergeant. And I've now changed it to a power fist with the rule changes from 6th edition to from 5th to 6th. So I built two 10-man tactical squads with a sergeant in each and a melter gun, pre-heresy melter gun guy in each. Before the last big game that I did in August, I think it was, I was told I could actually stick heavy flamers in. Generally, I don't like putting heavy weapons in 10-man tactical squads. So I went out and I basically got two heavy flamer guys, the Legion of the Damned ones, and cut them up and converted them so that they can actually fit. Let me just bring this out and see if I can bring him into focus. Oh, there we go. So, yeah, this is the... the heavy weapons guy that I made back for then, and there's the other one for the other tactical squad. So they were quite good. And then what happened next, so there are two extra options, and we shall refocus on them all. There you go. What happened next was Forge World came out with this beautiful, heavy and expensive book called Betrayal. Inside Betrayal is a new set of rules for all the traitor legions and the legions in general, allowing a 20-man tactical squad. So I was like, yay, that's great. Problem. You're not allowed melter gun guys. So that's those two out. I can't have the heavy flamer guys. So that's those two out. And I can only have one sergeant. So there we go. So I remove all these guys and... although it's nice that I have them, so if I ever play 40k, I can actually use these guys for it. So this left me requiring three more guys to make a 20-man tactical squad, which I've just done. In fact, I'll show you these up close. Fiddle with the focus, fiddle with everything. Come on. You will focus, I know you will. Zoom in a bit as well. So, yet again, Forge World Mark V body and the very old 1990s bolter. And I've taken the Aquila off. I've done the mud effects. One guy's actually mentioned something a couple of times, and I have thought of this. I put nice mud on the boots, but I don't really put any mud on the kind of slab, the concrete. That's because I'm trying to find a very good pigment that I can turn into a pigment wash and pigment wash them all and then seal them in. But it's not just a case of finding the right pigment, it's finding the right pigment in the quantity I need, which is quite a lot. So that's the first one that I did. And here's the second guy. There you go. Drilled out the barrel and the sides. So quite simple really. Speed was a bit of an issue when it came to painting these guys. I really needed them done and done quite quickly. So, and that's the last of the guys. So there you go. That, he says, focus in and zoom out a little bit. That is a 20-man tactical squad, which these guys will be riding into battle on a Storm Eagle, which you saw in one of the previous videos. So that's one tactical squad now. So I've given them all bolters. They come with bolt pistols, and I've given them all chainswords as well, so they've got two attacks in hand-to-hand, and quite a versatile unit now. There's a lot more that you can do in the Betrayal. For the game, which is next weekend, I need to paint up two hand flamers, which I've got, from Forge World, finally. Yay. Finally showed up. I've got to just paint those two up, put them on two guys, to the assault guys. So you'll see a quick update on that. And I'll probably do a bit of an unboxing on the Forge World set, because there's actually quite a lot of nice little bits in there that I didn't realise, and I think would be handy for everyone to know and be able to see. So yeah, please comment, rate and subscribe, and I'll catch you all in the next one. Take care, guys.